When Jesus shall gather the nation before him at last to appear, then how shall we stand in the judgment when some on the same to be?
When Moses we kneel down for prayer.
To our most kind and loving Father who art above, indeed on that day, how shall we stand on the judgment day if it were not for the blood of Jesus Christ? We want to thank you in these precious moments, the holy hours that you have allowed us. All the week we have been engaged in different activities, but this culminates into the rest and recognition that you are indeed our Creator. So allow us to enter into this a holy convocation with you. As we start these Sabbath hours, may you be with us these very moments that we are going to listen to your main servant as he is going to speak to us. May we not see his face, but may we see you through the words that you have given to him. Until you come again to take us all home, saved by your grace, imbue us in your blood. In Jesus Christ we want to pray. Amen.
Let's have a word of prayer again. Father in heaven, we are asking you in a special way in this moment. Lord, please give us your Holy Spirit to guide us in this message tonight. As we will study from the Bible, Lord, help us to understand that it is time for us to go home. This is the time when we need to come closer and closer to you like never before. Please, Lord, help me as I present this message. Put your words in my mouth and let your holy name be praised here in this congregation. In Christ Jesus' name we pray, our Father. Amen. Amen. Before we start our message that it is entitled Lot's House and the Statue of Liberty. Lot's House and the Statue of Liberty, I want to ask you some questions regarding the topic that was presented yesterday. Can somebody help me and tell me where is that place on our planet where the persecution will start for the first time? This is United States of America. Thank you very much. Now, let me ask you another question. The National Sunday Law Movement, it will start from the top of the leaders of the United States of America, rulers and legislators, or it will start from the people, from the public, from the society, from the United States? What have you studied? That movement is starting from the bottom and it will reach to the top. Now, if this is clear, that means that in the United States of America, something needs to happen that the people may cry out to the leaders that the only solution is the Sunday law. This is clear?
Yes.
Okay. Then we have discovered in the Bible that the condition in this world, it will be just as the days of Sodom and Gomorrah. Yes? Then we have discovered that especially what country it will behave just like those two wicked cities. United States of America. We have read together the third angel's message from the book of Revelation chapter 14 that is saying that those people which are receiving the mark of the beast, they will receive from God fire and brimstone. And fire and brimstone, God has sent for the people from Sodom and Gomorrah. Now, the next question that I want to ask you is this one. When those sins of Babylon, they will reach up to heaven according to Revelation chapter 18, verse 4 and 5. When? At the National Sunday Law crisis. Let's go again to the book of Revelation chapter 18. Revelation chapter 18, our topic tonight is entitled Lot's House and the Statue of Liberty. Let's read together Revelation chapter 18 and we'll start reading beginning at verse 4 and 5. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, come out of her. Who is this her? This is that city, Babylon. Now look what the Bible is saying, what the Bible is saying in verse 8, that Jesus is saying that this wicked city, Babylon, it will be destroyed with fire, and God is saying to his people from Babylon that they need to come out. Look what the Bible is saying in verse 8. Therefore shall her plagues come in one day, death and mourning and famine, and she shall be utterly burned with fire, for the strong is the Lord God who judgeth her. So God is saying, come out from her, my people, come out from this wicked city called Babylon, come out from this city that it will be destroyed with fire. Why? Look what the Bible is saying in verse 4. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out from her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that we receive not of her plagues. So this calling of coming out from Babylon, because destruction is coming, fire is coming, is the call that it will be given before or after the outpouring of the seven last plagues. What does the Bible say? Before, Jesus is saying, come out from Babylon. Why? Because the plagues are coming. And we know in that moment when the plagues, they are present already, that means that Jesus have ended his ministry there in the heavenly sanctuary. That means that that is the final and the general close of human probation. That's clear. So this final call of coming out from Babylon, from that city that it will be burned with fire, God is saying, come out from it, my people, because the plagues are coming. But verse 5 is saying, when this final call, it will start to be given, first in United States of America, and then it will increase into the entire world in a loud cry message. Look what the Bible is saying in verse 5. For her sins have reached unto heaven, and God hath remembered her. So this time, that is before that pouring of the seven last plagues, this time when it is the final fall of Babylon, is the moment when the sins of Babylon have finally reached where? Unto heaven, and God hath remembered her iniquities. Let's look again and remind ourselves why God did to remember the iniquities and sins of Babylon at this moment. Hebrews chapter 10, beginning at verse 16. Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10, beginning at verse 16. I'm so happy to be here, my brothers and my sisters. I'm so happy to be here with my brothers and sisters in Christ that they have a burden for their salvation. I'm so happy to see parents staying to their children, showing them from the Bible that what we are studying, indeed it is written in the Bible. Indeed it is written there in the spirit of prophecy. And God is willing to open our eyes and to understand that we are living in the last days and the time is short. And we need, as never before, as we understand that we are living in the last days, my brothers and my sisters, we need to reflect that image that Pastor Jeremiah was preaching, reflect the full image of Jesus Christ. And we don't have a lot of time for doing this. As we understand how near we are to that Sunday law crisis, our efforts should be to prepare as never before.
Amen.
Look what the Bible is saying. Why God did to remember the sins and iniquities of Babylon? Hebrews chapter 10, beginning at verse 16. This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws into their hearts, and in their minds will I write them. And their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. So what is the condition that God is trying to that each one of us may have, that he will not remember our sins and iniquities? His law has to be where? In our heart, in our minds. And if we have this experience, God, it will not remember our sins and our iniquities. Let me say it to you very clear. We cannot be more wiser than God. Let me say it to you. If God, it will not be able to remember our sins and iniquities, that means that if you remember, you remain faithful to God, you will not be able to remember your sins and your iniquities.
Amen.
Because you will not be able to know things that not even God is able to remember them. Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm trying to say to you, my brothers and my sisters, that it will come a time soon in this earth's history where every of our sins, we will not be able to remember them. We will not be able. All that pressure, all those sins that are affecting us right now, when we look back in our Christian experience, God, it will blot them out, all of them. But the time is now when we need to send our sins to Jesus Christ. Some, they will send their sins right now. And some people, they will run and confess sins, but only Satan, he will answer their prayers. My brothers and my sisters, that means that when the sins of Babylon, they will reach to heaven, it is because Babylon has rejected to put the law of God in the mind and in the... So what is that moment in earth's history, just before the outpouring of the seven last plagues, when Babylon, it will fall? Then Jesus is saying, come out, my people from Babylon. Why? Because they have rejected my law. What is that Bible event? Last day event in Bible prophecy. National Sunday law crisis. Look what Ellen White said. We are coming to this point. Look what he is saying in the book Maranatha, page 179. The prophet says, I saw another angel came down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon, the great is fallen. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues, for her sins have reached unto heaven, and God had remembered her iniquities. When do her sins reach unto heaven? When the law of God is finally made void by... So this is the National Sunday law. Is it clear till this moment?
Amen.
We are studying. I'm not going to preach tonight. We will run through the Bible. Our message, Lord's house and the Statue of Liberty, my brothers and my sisters, tonight, and by God's grace, tomorrow if we are living, we'll go from this camp meeting and we'll say clearly, Jesus is coming. We will take these DVDs, these presentations, these books that are here, and we'll have a burden from our brothers and sisters. Do you know that as I'm speaking right now, there are people that we do love that are sitting right now in our churches, Seventh-day Adventist churches here in England, in my country, in Romania, back there in the United States, there in Africa, and the people are crying in their heart because they don't receive the message. They don't receive food. They don't receive it, my brothers and my sisters. We have family members back to our homes, brother, sister, mother, father. And when we are looking to their experience, we can see that they don't know the things that God has allowed us to see at this camp meeting. And we need to go back home and start the ministry from our homes. There is no use to plant the seed in the world, in the field of the world, if our garden from the front of the house is destroyed. Jesus is saying, if I want to see you responsible for other souls, start the work from your house. Because if you don't have a burden to pray and fast for your children, you will not pray never for your neighbor. You will never fast and pray for the other people from the church. If you don't have time for family altar at your home, you don't have time to pray for anyone. My brothers and my sisters, that is the final moment when the sins of Babylon, they will reach up to heaven. That means that these sins are increasing. It is a final sin, but before that sin, there is another sin. Question: where in the Bible we see an image with a voice that is saying, even a voice from heaven, from the angels of heaven, which are saying, come out from this city that it will be destroyed with fire, because the sins have reached out to heaven. What we have studied, where is this?
Genesis.
In Genesis chapter 18, verse 20. The Bible says that in Sodom and Gomorrah, in that moment, the sins reach up to heaven, and Jesus with two angels, how many angels?
Two
angels came to those cities to see the things of Sodom. Now let me ask you, what was the prevalent sin in Sodom and Gomorrah?
Homosexuality.
That strange flesh after the people were trying to go here and there. Now, let me say to you this. There are people that they will listen this message, and most probably you have heard many sermons about Lost Time and Sodom and Gomorrah. Somebody will say, Brother Andrew, this sin of homosexuality has been from a long time. What makes you believe that this sin, it will push us into the National Sunday Law? And we have seen, my brothers and my sisters, that when those, how many angels went in Sodom?
Two
angels went in Sodom. Then after they gather around Lot's house, then they start putting their hands to put on the angels, to destroy the angels. Do you think what would have happened if Jesus Christ was going in that wicked city, the creator of the universe? The people, they have been so deceived by the devil. If it was possible, they would have taken Jesus to touch him. But tonight we will study why Jesus was not present there. Because those two angels, they have been present there to teach us a lesson. Now, we said that when we will see Lot's house being surrounded by this homosexual movement, especially in what country?
America.
America. And what was the condition in those days? What was happening in Lot's experience? What was Lot doing in there? What he was doing? He was crying. He was crying. He was lamenting when he saw the wicked things that were happening there. Lot was crying even in his home. But the Bible is saying when we will see this house surrounded by this homosexual movement, the next event that it will happen, they will try to take and put their hand on the angels. Now, let's look in the Bible first to understand what is a house a symbol in the Bible. A house in the Bible is symbolizing a church. We know that a house is symbolizing a family, but it's also a church. Let's go together in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 3. 1 Timothy chapter 3. Now we are starting to study. 1 Timothy chapter 3. And we will start reading beginning at verse 15. Look how the Bible is saying. But if I tarry long, that thou mayest know how thou oughtest to behave thyself in the house of God, which is the church of the living God, the pillar and ground of. So a house, help me, is a symbol of what? Is a symbol of what? A church. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 3. Hebrews chapter 3, and we'll read from there verse 6. Hebrews chapter 3, and we'll read from there verse 6. Look what the Bible is saying. But Christ as a son over his own house, whose house we are, if we hold fast the confidence and the rejoicing of hope firm unto the end. So a house in the Bible is a symbol of a church. So when the Bible is speaking about Lot's house being surrounded by this homosexual movement there in Sodoma, we are seeing this Lot church that was there in Sodom being surrounded by this homosexual movement. Now the question is, okay, we understand that a house in the Bible is a symbol of a church, but is Lot's church that was in Sodom? Now, if we need to understand this thing, we have to understand first where the sin of sodomy started in the beginning. I want to tell you, my brothers and my sister, that sin didn't start there. If you look in Genesis chapter 13, verse 13, the Bible is saying that when Lot decided to go in Sodom, that sin was already being done there. But in this moment, reach a climax. Almost reach unto heaven, and Jesus said, I need to go down. Go with me in the book of Genesis chapter 9. Let's see where this sin started. First started in Noah's family. Where he started? In Noah's family. Can you believe it? Look here. One of the sons of Noah was interested to look to a man. Look what the Bible is saying. In Genesis chapter 9, beginning at verse 20, look what the Bible is saying. And Noah began to be a husbandman, and he planted a vineyard, and he drank of the wine and was drunken, and he was uncovered within his tent. And Ham, the father of Canaan, who? Ham, remember this, put a sign there in the Bible. Ham, the father of Canaan, look what the Bible is saying, saw the nakedness of his father and told his two brethren without. So Noah was naked inside his tent. Ham was entering inside. He saw the nakedness of his father, and instead of turning his eyes away to cover his father's nakedness, he was looking to his father, and then he went and started speaking what he saw to his brethren. Now look what the Bible continued to say. And Noah awake from his wine and knew what his younger son has seen unto him. What the Bible says? Has done unto him. Not only if you read in the chapter Tower of Babel and the chapter before, you will understand that was not just watching. It was not just watching. This son, Ham, the father of Canaan, was the first one to introduce the sin of homosexuality. This wicked thing, this nakedness. Here is the, let's say, the origin of this wickedness that we are seeing in the televisions, in cinemas, and magazines, and all these things. Now, my brothers and my sisters, let me say you, Ham was the one that to this lineage, he established Sodom and Gomorrah, and from him even the Tower of Babel. I want to say to you that according to the Bible, Sodom and Gomorrah, they have been daughters of Babylon. Let me show it from the Bible. Look what the Bible is saying in the book of Genesis chapter 10. Starting at verse 1, look what the Bible is saying. Now these are the generations of the sons of Noah. Sem, Ham, Japheth, and unto them were sons born after the flood. Now let's read verse 6. Now, and the sons of Ham. Who was Ham? Was the one that saw the nakedness of his father and went to his brethren and spoke what he saw. Now look what the Bible is saying. And the sons of Ham, Cush and Mitzrayim and Hut and Canaan. So the son of Ham was Cush. Now look what the Bible is saying, beginning at verse 9. And Cush begat. So Ham gave birth to Cush. And from Cush, who is the next one? Nimrod. Now look what the Bible is saying about Nimrod. He began to be a mighty one on the earth. He was a mighty hunter before the Lord. Therefore he said, even as Nimrod, the mighty hunter before the Lord. And the beginning of his kingdom was Babel. Now look what the Bible is saying. From Ham, Ham began who? Cush. And from Cush who?
Nimrod.
The one who established what? Babel. In the place of Shinar, the place of Babylon. Go to the book of Daniel chapter 1 and 1, and you will see that Shinar was the place where the Babylon was being established. Now look what the Bible is saying. After you are reading, if you are looking at verse 19, and the border of the Canaanites was from Sidon, as thou comest to Gerar, and to Gaza, as thou goest unto Sodom, and Gomorrah, and Admah, and Zeboim, even unto. And if you're reading, you will see that Nimrod was the one through this lineage that established all these wicked cities. He has been the one who established Babylon, but in the same time, Sodom and Gomorrah. That means that Sodom and Gomorrah, they are daughters of what? Babylon. That means that when God said to Lot, come out from Sodom, he was saying, come out from Babylon. Why? Because fire is coming from heaven. Fire and brimstone. Why? Because the sin has reached unto heaven. And this homosexuality thing is surrounding the churches of Babylon. The churches that are Lord's church there in Babylon are surrounding. And these people which are present in these churches are weeping, are start crying to see those wicked things that are happening. And the next thing they will do, they will say, we need the Sunday law. We need the enforcement of the mark of the beast, because it's too late. Now, Brother Andrew, look what the Bible is saying in Isaiah chapter 13. Isaiah chapter 13, beginning at verse 19. You will see God is speaking frequently about Sodom and Gomorrah and Babylon being in the same cup. Look what the Bible is saying. Isaiah chapter 13. Isaiah chapter 13. And we will read together beginning at verse 19. The Bible is saying, and Babylon, the glory of kingdoms, the beauty of the Chaldeans, exceedingly, shall be as when God overthrew what? Sodom and. So you see, God is saying, what I will do to Babylon, I have already done it to whom? To Sodom and Gomorrah. Now, let's come back. Have you understood so far?
Yes.
It was clear. Now let me say to you, when Jesus said to Lot through those how many angels?
Two angels.
He said, come out from Sodom. He was saying, come out from Babylon. Lot, come out. But you know, the reason why those angels have been two, it is because Lot has been asked one to come out from Babylon and he turned back again. Look what the Bible is saying in Genesis chapter 12. Let's see from where God took Abraham and Lot. From what place? Genesis chapter 12. And we will read beginning at verse 1. Look what the Bible is saying here. My brothers and my sisters, are you blessed by this study? Do you see what I see? My brothers and my sisters, I have prayed for this study and for the study tomorrow and the days that there remain. There are so many things that we need to study. The time is short.
But I'm praying as we'll study this thing to understand, Lord, it is clear you are coming. This movement is surrounding these churches. Lord's church is being surrounded and he's crying, he's weeping, and the next thing, they will put their hand on the angels. They will enforce the national Sunday law. Look what the Bible is saying in the book of Genesis chapter 12, starting at verse 1. Now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house and to a land that I will show thee. Now look what verse 2 is saying. And I will make of thee a great nation. And I will bless thee and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. So the Lord was saying to Abraham, come out from your country, come out. And in that moment when Abraham decided to come out, he has taken Lot with him. From what country? God said, come out from Babylon. Look what the Bible is saying in Genesis chapter 11. Genesis chapter 11, starting at verse 31. And Terah took Abraham, his son, and Lot, the son of Haran, his son's son, and Sarai, his daughter-in-law, his son, Abraham's wife, and they went forth with them from of the to go into a land of Canaan, and they came unto Haran and dwelt there. So from what country God said to Abraham and Lot to come out? From Ur. This name Ur, if you are looking in the original, it is being translated as being the light of the Chaldeans. Now let me ask you, what is this term Chaldeans? To what is pointing? To Babylon. Let's go into Isaiah chapter 47. Isaiah chapter 47. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, this is not my language. If I will have the possibility to speak in another language that can be understood better than my brothers and sisters, I will do it. Lord, please help us to understand. Mm-hmm. There is no more time.
Amen.
You are coming soon, and we need to reflect fully the image of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Look what the Bible is saying. Look what the Bible is saying in Isaiah chapter 47, verse 1. Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground. There is no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans, for thou shalt no more be called tender and
delicate.
So Chaldeans are a title for what?
Babylon.
For Babylon. So when God said to Abraham and Lot, come out from your country, God was saying, come out from where?
Babylon.
Come out from Babylon. But what happened, my brothers and my sisters, with Lot? He go back in Sodom and Gomorrah. That means he went back where? He went back in Babylon. So Lot's house, a house is pointing to a
church.
That means that this church is representing those churches that they have come out once from the
Babylon,
but they turned back again where? That is the reason why we have two angels and not three. Now let's see why God asked Abraham and Lot to come out from Babylon. Go with me to the book of Nehemiah chapter 9 verse 7. Nehemiah chapter, I think it's chapter 7 verse 9. Sorry. Chapter 7 verse 9. Look what the Bible is saying here. No, it's 9 chapter 7. Yes, 9 chapter 7. Look what the Bible is saying. Nehemiah chapter 9 verse 7. The Bible is saying, thou art the Lord, the God, who did choose Abraham and brought us him forth out of Ur of the Chaldees and gave us him his name, him the name of, and found us his heart faithful before thee, and made us a covenant with. So do you see the reason why God said to Abraham to come out? Because he saw something in his heart. What God saw in Abraham's heart? He was what?
He was faithful. Joshua chapter 24. Joshua chapter 24. And we will read beginning at verse 1 and 2. And Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and called for the elders of Israel and for their heads and for their judges and for their officers, and they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said unto all the people, thus says the Lord God of Israel, your fathers dwelt on the other side of the flood in old time, even Terah, the father of Abraham and the father of Nahor, and they served other gods. So the reason why God was saying to Abraham, come out from Babylon, is because there the people were worshiping other gods, even the sun god, even the light of the Babylon, that was false worship. And God was saying, come out from Babylon, come out. But what happened with Lot? He decided to come back. Now let me say to you, the Bible is saying that the reason why Abraham went out from Babylon is because he listened to the gospel of righteousness by faith. Galatians chapter 3 verse 8. Now, after two texts, we can establish clear who Lot's house represents. Look what the Bible is saying in the book of Galatians chapter 3. Galatians chapter 3, and we want to read together beginning at verse 8. Look what the Bible is saying. Galatians chapter 3, beginning at verse 8. And the scripture, foreseeing that God would justify the heathen through faith, preached before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, in thee shall all nations be. So what was the reason why Abraham and Lot decided to come out from Babylon? They listened to the gospel. But something happened. Abraham and Lot were together, but in a moment, Lot decided to go back. Now, let me say to you, do you know, be careful, that in the moment when God said to Abraham and Lot to come out, they were having no understanding about the seal of God, the sign of circumcision. And they have been accounted righteous by faith with no understanding about this thing. But after that coming out, Jesus decided to give to Abraham that seal, that mark, but Lot was already gone back to Babylon. Because in Genesis chapter 13, that split was taking place, but the seal of God, that mark, that circumcision was given in Genesis chapter 17. But Lot was not present in that moment. Look what the Bible is saying in Romans chapter 4. Romans chapter 4, look what the Bible... What was Lot doing there in the house, my brothers and my sisters? He was praying, he was weeping. They are weeping, and they are weeping so much, but they are not weeping so much to come out from that city. You know why? Because the angels, the Seventh-day Adventist people, they are not going to give them the message. And they are staying there and they are crying. They are crying, my brothers and my sisters. Do you know what? Because they have been deceived. What was the reason why Abraham and Lot came out from Babylon in the first place? They received what? They received the gospel of righteousness by faith. But then they come, went back to Babylon. That means they have received another gospel. And you know what this gospel is saying? This gospel is saying that you can be saved in your sins. This gospel is saying that Jesus died on the cross. That means that with the sin problem is solved. That means that the grace of Jesus is sufficient. That means that whatever sin do you have, Jesus is able to forgive you. But right now the people are saying, okay, if this is the truth, this is the sin that I want to have, homosexuality. But they are saying no. But they cannot realize how foolish is this gospel that they have embraced. They are crying. And the people ask him, but you have said to us that you can have all these sins and Jesus is able to forgive us. All these sins, but not homosexuality. the same thing is happening even in our Seventh-day Adventist churches. And the people are crying, look what is happening. Virginia intercessors launched 40 days of prayer, fasting, and repentance to stand for marriage. They are weeping. They are crying. Lord's house is being surrounded. Could judgment be far off? American support for gay marriage reaches all-time high. The house is being surrounded. God save America. I showed you yesterday, school show Christian same-sex marriage propaganda video. Great controversy, page 590. The miracle working power manifested through spiritualism will exert its influence against those who choose to obey God rather than man. Communications from the Spirit will declare that God has sent them to convince the rejecters of Sunday of the era, affirming that the laws of the land should be obeyed as the law of God. They will lament. Who will lament? The spirits will lament. They will lament the great wickedness in the world, and especially in what country? In the world. And second, the testimony of religious that the... So these spirits, they will say what those religious leaders, they are saying is true. That means that in America, religious leaders, they will say this wickedness is because we are not enforcing Sunday worship. They will lament the great wickedness in the world, and second, the testimony of religious teachers that the degraded state of morals is caused by the desecration of Sunday. Great will be the indignation excited against all who refuse to accept their testimony. My brothers and my sisters, I want to ask you, we have seen this. I want to ask you, when Lot is crying there in that house, in that church, is God is able to hear them? Yes or no? What Jesus decided to do when he heard those cries? He said, I'm coming down. I want to see it. Because I have my people there that I want them to be saved. Mm-hmm. And he said, those angels, he said, come out. Come out, my people. Come out, because this city will be destroyed. My brothers and my sisters, I see here the love of Jesus Christ. We are repeating the same history. Everything is being fulfilled in our very eyes. And Jesus is saying, I love you. I'm coming after you. I want you to understand from the Bible what is happening in these days, because time shall be no more. And we need to reflect fully the image of Jesus Christ. Wrath of God, gay marriage is the reason why UK was hit by floods. Conchita Ross caused Balkan floods after Eurovision win, say church leaders. I want to say to you, when I was back in Romania last year, even this year, when this contest of music was happening in Europe, I don't know how many of you have seen the picture of that one, or she or he, I don't know what is it. Now, when those things were happening, let me say to you, we were studying the book of Revelation with my students there in Romania, the medical missionary school, about Revelation chapter 11, when the Bible is saying in verse 18, the nations are angry and thy wrath is come. And we start dissecting that Bible passage, and as I was checking my emails, send letters, newsletters, asking the questions from the people, everywhere was that picture. Everywhere. Especially in Europe, I don't know in the States, but in Europe, in those men, everywhere, when every website, that picture came. And when I look at that thing, I said, Lord, I know what the Bible is saying, but it's much deeper. And I went into my room in a break, and for 10 minutes, I sit down, I prayed, and I said to the Lord, Lord, please, please show me what is happening right now. And God said to me, because we are studying about the clause of probation, that is the meaning of Revelation chapter 11, verse 18.
Thy wrath is come. Wrath is come in the book of Revelation is the time when the seven last plagues, it will be poured out. That is the close of probation. But before that time, the nations will be angry. And then I was looking to all the Bible passages in the Bible that they were describing the close of human probation. And I went straight to Isaiah chapter 59. Look what the Bible is saying in Isaiah chapter 59. Isaiah chapter 59. And I want to read with you starting at verse 12. Isaiah chapter 59, starting at verse 12. Look what the Bible is saying. For our transgressions are multiplied before thee, and our sins testify against us. For our transgressions are with us, and as for our iniquities, we knew them. In transgressing and lying against the Lord, and departing away from our God, speaking oppression and revolt, conceiving and uttering from the heart words of falsehood, and judgment is turned away backward. And justice standeth afar off, for the truth is fallen in the street, and iniquity cannot enter. Yea, truth faileth. Where is the truth being? Where is this truth being fallen? How is the Bible saying? In the streets. Now, the Bible is saying, and he that departed from evil maketh himself a prey, and the Lord saw it. What does the Lord saw it? What does the Lord saw? That the truth is fallen where? On the streets. And he saw that those people, that they were trying to take the truth from the street, down from the street, they become a prey. Now look what the Bible is saying. And the Lord saw it. Then it displeased him that there was no judgment. And he saw that was no man. And he wondered that there was no intercessor. Therefore his arm brought salvation unto him, and his righteousness he sustained him. For he put on righteousness as a breastplate, and a helmet of salvation upon his head. And he put on the garments of vengeance for holding, and he clad with zeal as a cloak. Let me ask you, when will Jesus took a garment out and he will put another garment, even the garment of vengeance upon himself? At the close of human probation. Do you see it? Have you been able to follow me so far? Now listen to me. Before the close of human probation, the truth, it will remain, it will be fallen where? In the street. And those people, listen, that they will want to take the truth from the streets, they will become a? And I was looking at this Bible passage. I saw here is the close of human probation. Lord, please, please, Lord, tell me why this thing is happening in Europe. And the Lord said to me, Andrew, where in the Bible do you see truth being fallen, even killed in the streets? Then persecution is starting. Revelation chapter 11, the French Revolution. Look what the Bible is saying. Revelation chapter 11. My brothers and my sisters, as I was praying, that verse hit me. And I went there, and here is the connection with the Statue of Liberty. Look what the Bible is saying here. Revelation chapter 11. Revelation chapter 11, and we want to read Revelation chapter 11. We want to read starting at verse 7. And when they, who are these they? The two witnesses. And when they shall have finished their testimony, the beast that ascended out from the bottomless pit shall make war against them, and shall overcome them and kill them. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of that great city, which spiritually is called Sodom, and where also our Lord was. Don't men tell me that Jesus was crucified in Egypt or in Sodom. You know what this Bible is saying? That God's people, they will be persecuted in that time. My brothers and my sisters, after papacy has done that terrible work during 1,260 years, another beast came from the abyss, France. papacy was persecuting the people in the name of God, in the name of the Bible. But France, atheistic France, when they came to power, he persecuted God's people, not in the name of the Bible, with no respect for the Bible. The Bible, they have been burned in the streets. And Jesus is saying, before the close of human probation, you will see truth fallen in the streets like in the days of French Revolution, when the principles of sodomy, they have been pushed in that country. And here we are. Look here. Will America be judged? We have looked at this. Who is this? The Supreme Court of Justice, yes? We have seen that this Supreme Court of Justice is in the hands of whom? Catholicism. We have looked here, we have read from Great Controversy, page 581, that the influence of Roman Catholicism is, her doctrines are accepting their influence in the legislative force. Now look here. The marriage and the Sabbath had their origin twin. And if the marriage institution has fallen in America, by law, what is the next institution that it will fall? The Sabbath, my brothers. Now, why the Protestant church, they are crying in America, help us. And they will stretch their hand to call for this man who is pushing for the families. Tomorrow we'll learn more about this. But when this house is being surrendered, do you know that even 7 days